We know that frogs are amphibians. Amphibians are the animals that can live on land as well as in water. So frogs breathe through lungs when they are on land, and when they are in water, they breathe through their skin. Okay, so frogs, they breathe through their lungs when they are on land, and they breathe through their skin when they are in water. Then see here in the figure, let us see the frog. Okay, so can you see the frog there? It has lungs, it has nostrils, mouth cavity. So it's taking in the oxygen. When it's in water, it breathes through the skin. So it's taking in oxygen through the skin and it's giving out carbon dioxide. Okay, so this way the frogs breathe. Then insects, they have air holes called spiracles. Okay, they have air holes called spiracles, which is a network of tubes. Okay, these spiracles or these air holes are the network of tubes called the trachea. See, look here, the insect, can you see? Now these spiracles, they form a tracheal system. Okay, so insects breathe through this tracheal system. So insects have small air holes called spiracles, which lead to a network of tubes called trachea that helps them in breathing. Now how do birds breathe? Birds have air sac and lungs both. Okay, so they have air sac and lungs, which they use for the process of breathing.